Greetings from Jacksonville, Arkansas. Today is Thursday, September the 19th, and it is 2024, and the time is approximately 8:54 p.m. You guys, I am filming this video, and my question is who exactly is running Facebook? Who owns it, okay? I mean, like, is it foreign-based? Is it American-based? Y'all, the reason why I'm filming this is because I just posted something to my Find Maria Jackson's account. I have two accounts. I have Yolanda Smith, that's me, and then my daughter is Maria Jackson. So, and I put Find Maria because I haven't seen her in years. So there's someone or something that is cloaked and invisible, and that is very desperate to make it look like I don't even exist, okay? So somebody is very desperate. I understand if I posted some nudity or maybe cuss words and stuff, but that I didn't post that at all. Y'all know it's election time, right? I'm talking Donald Trump and Kamala Harris. So what I did was I shared content from the election that was posted that I posted and shared on Twitter, which is now the letter X. And this is what this says. The moment, twice they deleted it. So I posted it and it disappeared. And then I went back and reposted it. And then it says, this is what it says from Facebook. Find Maria Jackson, September 19th, 2024. Mind you, it is Thursday. Seeing is believing. Okay, it says, this is what I posted. This is what I posted. And it says, I love Donald Trump and his authenticity. You know, he's an authentic person. So his opponent, Kamala, is a good speaker. I'm not sure about this public school. And it's supposed to be, I'll show you what exactly I put in the post. And then it says, this goes against our community standards on cybersecurity. And then see the rules. And I'm going to show you guys what I posted. So let's see what goes against their cybersecurity. So I want to request a review, okay? It says, repeatedly breaking our rules can cause more account restrictions. And then it says, how we made this decision. I want to request a review. And it says, cybersecurity post removed, September 19th, 2024. Why do you want another review? First of all, I never made a review. That's crazy. And then the restriction is too harsh. You understood this post? Oh, you misunderstood this post. So this is the options. So I'm requesting a review, okay? So I'm basically appealing the decision to remove my post. I will show you guys exactly the full post of what they removed here in a second. And by the way, if I didn't say so, I'm in Jacksonville, Arkansas. So the reason why I'm requesting a review, it says, what do you want another review? Select the main reasons or get help. The restriction is too harsh. You misunderstood this post. This post doesn't break the rules. Posts like mine should be allowed or something else. So I want to put, you misunderstood this post, or this post doesn't break the rules. Okay. I'm going to put, this post doesn't break the rules. Because if I put posts like mine should be allowed, it doesn't break the rule. And then I'm going to go to continue. What should we know about your post? It was to raise awareness. It was about an important issue. It's not offensive in my region. I was responding to someone else. It was a joke. No, it's not a joke. I'll put... it was about an important issue. It's not offensive in my region. I was responding to someone else. It was to raise awareness. Okay. Continue. Why do you want another review? This post doesn't break the rule. What should we know about your post? It was to raise awareness. What we'll do, we'll update you within a few days. Your case will be looked at again by our technology or reviewers. We'll use the additional information, okay? We'll use the additional info you gave us to improve our system. We aim to respect your free expression while keeping the community safe. So click submit. Now it says in review, Facebook. It says you'll hear back from us soon. Thanks for requesting a review. We'll let you know when we've made a decision. Most people hear back in less than 4 days, but it can take longer. And then about this, what is this? What you need to know about this review? I'm just going to click done. Okay. Y'all, this is ridiculous. It's somebody or entity that perhaps has my deaf daughter, Maria Jackson. You guys, that picture right there that you see on her, Find Maria Jackson, that is my daughter, Maria. She's hearing impaired. I haven't seen her in many years. And I actually have contacted the courts and the judicial system, the Department of Homeland Security, including the feds, in regards to my daughter's whereabouts. And I've requested that they find her. And because I'm requesting a welfare check on her, her records is botched up. So whoever's running Facebook, it's an entity that done that. And it keeps doing the same, something similar like on Google, on YouTube. So if you, whoever you are, understand if I posted something offensive, then I could expect that to be removed. But this is what I actually posted. So whoever you are, get a life. One moment, you guys, let me show you. Okay, you guys, this is Twitter, known as X now. So this is me, Yolanda Smith. And so I'm going to click on profile. And as you can see under my Twitter account, I just want to share with you before I show you what I posted, that this background picture is a picture of a bird in the sky. It's either a falcon or an eagle, okay? When I first posted it, it was like extra lights in the sky when I lived in Asheville, North Carolina, before I returned back home to Arkansas. So anyways, I saw extra lights in the sky, like extra suns, and in a broad open daylight. So I took pictures, multiple photos. And when I got home, I looked at it, and it was like a little rainbow planet on the sun, extra sun. And this is what it shows, like a falcon, like an Egyptian falcon or some type of bird there. And then before that, I had seen like the all-seeing Egyptian eye, and, you know, they'd be cloaked up there in the sky, and also seen a man with a sword, you know, but they don't show you usually all the time. They're real full image. They usually just show like, you know, extra light, like extra suns, and there should be only like one sun in the sky, right? So you guys, here's what I posted under my Twitter account, and I decided to share it to my other social medias. As some apps like Instagram, they automatically will ask you if you want to post your content directly to Facebook. You know, I don't have that feature turned on. I may have had it on and I turned it off, but I'm just saying, so why would Facebook get upset with me posting content from my Twitter? So here's what, that's just my profile information that says, although I have traveled to Egypt. Okay, so right here, I say under my profile that although I traveled to Egypt, etc., I have not seen my hearing impaired, aka deaf daughter, Maria Jackson, since I lived in the Texarkana area of Northeast Texas. That would be the Hooks, Texas area. And so Anyways, you guys, that's just, you know, they just limit what you're able to put there. We know that Twitter is limited to location. So they show the nearest city and state that I'm, well, they show the nearest city that I'm in. They show Little Rock. They're not going to put Jacksonville, Arkansas there. So you guys, they don't have Jacksonville, Arkansas on Twitter location. So anyways, here is what I posted, you guys, that Facebook removed, claiming that I'm breaking rules. Okay, so we know that Donald Trump is on Twitter. He got his Twitter account back, right? So I was actually at the Donald Trump Twitter page because I received a notification that, you know, that he had posted something, and I'm not even literally following him, but I've been getting like notification from different people on Twitter. And I mean, I don't necessarily follow the people that I get notifications from. I don't know why I try to turn that feature off, but anyways, there was an article, and I'm gonna first show you how I respond, and then I'm gonna click on the video itself. I said, I love Donald Trump and his authenticity. Okay, that's like being authentic. And then his opponent, Kamala, is a good speaker. I'm not sure about this public school incident involving Kamala. I wish the child a speedy recovery. Perhaps the school could allow the student to attend school virtually. So you guys, that's all I posted. This is what Facebook deleted. Okay, so I'm gonna show you the original post. All right, hold on. So this original post was posted on like Trump Daily, right? And let me just click on that. Let me show you what was the original post. The original post came from Donald J. Trump Daily. And it says, Comrade Kamala Harris exposed. Donald Trump, Truth, Social, you know. Anyways, 4:06 p.m. That is the post. Right here is a video that I made my reply to. So this is what this is in reference to. So I'm just going to play it. Hold on 1 second. Okay, you guys, this is the original post. I don't own the original content. I did not post this. As you can see, this post, let me pause this. This video was posted by Donald J. Trump Post at Trump Daily Post on Twitter. And I'm going to try to turn the volume up on this. All right, and then this is what I was replying to. It's about this mother who claims that Kamala Harris, who was a senator or something, had her arrested for truancy because her daughter that has sickle cell anemia had missed too many days out of school. And I was just saying that I'm not sure about the incident, but I'm about to change that over there. Hold on. So just picking up right here, I said that what I was saying is that in this video, it says that this mother says that she was arrested while Kamala Harris was in office. And I was just replying saying I'm not sure about the incident, but I was just trying to like bring awareness and try to provide a resolution, saying that I wish the child that has sickle cell anemia a speedy recovery, and that I hope that the public schools could allow the child to attend studies, you know, like virtually, you know, by computer if she's not physically feeling well enough to attend school. You know that they limit what you can actually say in these posts on Twitter because I ran out of characters, so I had to like chop it down. But that's what I meant. I didn't mean to offend anybody if that's what Facebook thought I was doing. So here goes. I was just trying to make awareness and provide a solution to this incident of a sick child in the hospital. And she, this mother said that Kamala had her arrested for truancy. Now, I can understand if this mother was like a junkie, you know what I mean? Like a bad mother. But no, it's a sick child that need, you know, that had to be in the hospital. And so I was just wishing a child a speedy recovery. And I was just trying to offer a solution to the problem and not be, you know, part of the problem. So here goes. Seeing is believing. I'm going to play it.
Black lives matter to her. Why didn't I matter? Because of truancy, California Public Schools lose $1.4 billion a year in funding.
Sorry about the shakiness. I'm trying to get it where you guys can hear it.
I don't agree what my Kamala Harris did to my mom. So I decided I was going to start prosecuting parents for truancy.
And I spend a majority of my time here at the hospital.
When Kamala Harris was the California Attorney General, she had me arrested and prosecuted because my handicapped daughter was sick in the hospital and had missed some days of school.
I have sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia is a hereditary disease and it is very, very painful.
In 2012, like all California parents, I received a threatening letter from Kamala Harris saying, we'll go to jail for a year if our kids even miss 10% of school days. Little did I know, there was a warrant out for my arrest. All of a sudden, the police is outside my house.
Okay, you guys, I didn't play the full video. You can find the full video content online. I'm just going to wrap it up and leave it as is. I just want to film this for the records. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hey, you guys, if you see anything phony out there where you're posting content and or you're being blocked from uploading and stuff, that's an entity. And so be sure if your account has ever been blocked from uploading videos, if you're talking about YouTube, I'm talking about YouTube, and if your account has ever been blocked from posting, just in this case, you know, just you know, an update on the elections and Kamala Harris and Donald Trump and all that good stuff, y'all, that's an entity that is trying to block, you know, me from voicing my opinion. So I'm out. That's all I wanted to share with you guys. I'll see you in the next.